Judge Andrew Napolitano, and happy to be. Hey, Judge, thanks for joining us. So,
you've spent
the last, well, the 20 years I've known you, talking about civil liberties and how central they are to the American experiment. They're enshrined in our documents, of course. I haven't heard any talk about them recently. Are they still relevant?
You know, one of our colleagues sent me a cartoon of the framers signing the Constitution, and in this cartoon, Washington turns to Madison and says, "Let me get this straight. None of this counts if people get sick, right?" You know, sort of a humorous way of mocking what's happening today. Your analysis of Governor Whitmer could apply to nearly all the remaining 49 governors who assume that they have the power to crush individual liberties, violate the Constitution, and write laws. Well, they don't. Laws in this country are written by legislative branches after public hearings and debates, so there's a transparency. So we would know why she doesn't want you to buy garden hoses. There'd have to be a rational basis articulated for it. But when the executive branch takes upon itself the role of not just enforcing the law, but of making up new ones, and when in the process it crushes basic fundamental liberties, like the right to travel and the right to worship, never mind on Easter Sunday, but on any time you want to worship, we are witnessing the slow death, the death in slow motion of civil liberties, because these governors, these petty tyrants, will use this power again and again until some courageous federal court or an outraged public stops them.
I'm so thankful that you pointed out it's not just Governor Whitmer. I mean, it's Governor Hogan in Maryland, it's Governor Klanrobes in Virginia, it's virtually all of them. Very quickly, do you think there's a mechanism for pulling them back a little bit now?
Hopefully it'll be outrage stirred up by the type of reporting that you and some of our colleagues have begun to be doing, and even some of our colleagues on the left have been doing some of this reporting. But basic human liberties are guaranteed in the Constitution. They can't even be taken away by the vote of a legislature, much less the command of a governor or a mayor. These executive orders look like orders and sound like orders. They're just guidelines. They don't have the force of law. There cannot be a criminal sanction for the failure to comply with them, because they are at their root just the whim of those in power, intended to enhance their power.
Yes.
They're not valid expressions of constitutional doctrine.
Thank you for reminding us of that. Judge Napolitano, great to see you tonight. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.